Hey guys, what's happening? It's Cauliflower coming at you with a list of 10 laptops that students on a budget can buy for 2018. Sadly, school is almost starting again, but with that also comes a lot of fun things, like buying a new laptop for example. The laptops I've chosen all have the features I think are important for almost every college student out there. We're talking about battery life so they can at least last a day, portability, build quality, fast loading times, and of course the price. I know a lot of students do not have a huge budget to buy a new laptop, but they still want a good laptop that preferably will last them for their whole college career. That's why I've chosen the best value computers that are out there at the moment, so the best hardware you can get in a laptop for the price. I personally just finished my first year of computer science successfully, so previous year I went through the same struggle of buying a laptop that you guys are probably going through right now. I did a lot of research about laptop that I would pick and always saw a lot of videos promoting these ultra-light notebooks, but in my opinion these do not give you the best value for the price. You have a lot of better options out there for that price point. So that's why I wanted to make a video with more laptops oriented towards students on a budget that want the best value out of their money. So starting off, I want to say making a top 10 was almost impossible for the average student, since everyone has other expectations and desires about what they want from their laptop. For example, someone that just uses his laptop to take notes obviously needs another laptop than someone that wants to play games on it. That's why I split up my choices into three categories. The first category is the daily use laptops. These are the cheaper ones. They are perfect for taking notes in class, browsing the internet, and some smaller programs. They are capable of doing the things a laptop needs to do for just your average language student or medical student and other non-technical studies. The second category is for the people who need a little bit more out of their laptop than just browsing or less demanding programs. I call this category the all-around laptops. Maybe a graphical designer, an engineer, or even a programmer can use these laptops as a daily driver. These all have a dedicated graphics card, so you will be able to do more than just basic stuff. Lastly, we have a gaming category for people who want to game on their laptop, or maybe you just need to do some 3D rendering or other hard tasks with your laptop. If this is the case, then this might also be the category for you. For the daily use laptops, I've chosen to go with some cheaper laptops with an Intel Core i3 or a Core i5 and no dedicated graphics card. I think a lot of people that just use their laptop to take notes and to browse the internet are the ones that mostly give out the most unnecessary money, since you don't really need a Core i7 or a graphics card to do those type of things. So buying one seems like a waste to me if you don't really use the laptop to its full potential. An Intel Core i3 or Core i5 processor will most certainly get the job done, so why would you pay for more? The computers that we have running in our school only have a 6th generation Intel Core i3 CPU, and there were a lot of people in my class of computer science that did everything on those computers. They could do everything on them, even all of the programming we had to do. Therefore, the first laptop I picked is the Acer Aspire E15 for only $380. This one is packed with a new 8th generation Core i3. It has a full HD display, which is crazy at this price point. I certainly don't know how Acer was capable to pack all of this into this machine, with just a price tag of $380. A downside of this laptop is a 1TB hard drive, which is only 5400 RPM. But that's a compromise you have to make at this price point. It is easily swappable for an SSD, so for only $60 more you can have a crazy machine. It's no wonder that so many people buy the SSD together with the laptop. The second laptop I choose for the average students is the newest 2018 HP touchscreen 15-inch HD laptop. This machine comes with everything you need in a college laptop. The fact that it even has a touchscreen is also amazing. But the best part is the price. It comes in at only $500. The laptop has a new 8th generation Core i5, 8GB of DDR4 RAM, and 1TB of hard drive storage. Again, just 5400 RPM, which will again be the bottleneck, but it's upgradable, so that's a plus. The only downside I see with this laptop is that it does not have a full HD display. But that's actually normal in the price range, and considering all of the other features, it is still an amazing touchscreen laptop. The last laptop for this category will be the Asus VivoBook F510UA. This one has a Full HD display and also an 8th generation Core i5. It comes in at only $510. It has 1TB of hard drive storage, a fingerprint sensor and 8GB of DDR4 RAM. The only downside I see for this laptop is that the RAM is DDR3, which is an older and slower generation than the DDR4 we are used to. Again, the hard drive is only 5400 RPM, but easily upgradable. The next category is aimed towards a student that desires something more from their laptop than just taking notes or browsing the internet. I call them the all-around laptops. These laptops can easily handle tasks like Photoshop, amateur video editing, some 3D modeling and heavier programs, and even a little bit of gaming, even though these machines are not aimed towards the gamers. But still perfect for a graphic designer, engineering student, web designer or programmer. Starting we will do with the Acer Aspire 5, coming in at a whopping $550. It packs an 8th generation Core i5 with an Nvidia GeForce MX150 with 2GB of VRAM. This graphic card is a bit slower than the GTX 1050, but it's still a nice graphics card and still a big upgrade from no GPU at all. It also has 8GB of DDR4 RAM and a 256GB SSD, which will probably be enough storage for most people. It also comes with Alexa enabled, which is always a nice feature to have. The next models I'm about to show you are two thin and light laptops, which are very portable to take to class and most of them look really stylish. The downside of these laptops are the thermals and the price. You mostly have to pay premium for these laptops, but I've tried to keep the price as low as possible. The first one is the Asus VivoBook S Thin and Light. It has a Core i7-8550U, so also the new 8th Gen CPU. It has 8GB of DDR4, 256GB SSD, and also an Nvidia GeForce MX150 graphics card with 2GB of VRAM. It also has a fingerprint sensor and a backlit keyboard, which is nice to have. It has a slick design and really nice audio with the Sonic Master technology. The battery is 42 watt hours, which will last you for about 9 hours, so enough to get through the day. The laptop is only 14 inch, so a pretty small laptop, which makes it more portable. This laptop comes in at $950. The second thin and light laptop that I choose is actually the Pro variant, the Asus VivoBook Pro Thin and Light Laptop. In my opinion, it looks really nice, and it has all the features a flagship thin and light laptop must have, but only for 2/3 of the price. It will cost you $1,100. But for that price you get the 8th Gen Core i7, 16GB of RAM, a 256GB SSD and a 1TB hard drive. Asus really did a great job on their Vivo lineup, making these thin and light laptops affordable without many compromises. You also get a GTX 1050 with 4GB of VRAM. Most of the thin and light laptops don't even have a dedicated graphics card and they charge $200 more. Also, the display is one that you can expect from a thin and light flagship. It's a perfect laptop for a graphical designer or an architect. They advertise this laptop to have 8 hours of battery, but a lot of customers say 5 hours is a more realistic duration. So that's maybe something they have to work on. But with a dedicated graphics card and a new CPU, this machine draws a lot of power, so it's understandable. The last category, and probably where a lot of people have been waiting for, is a gaming category. The laptops for the guys that do not care about how thin or how heavy their laptop is. They don't care about taking their charger because the machine itself already weighs so much that you won't feel any difference. No, but some people just want the best hardware for the price. So yeah, let's jump right into it. The first laptop in this category is the Asus TUF Thin and Light Gaming Laptop. I don't really know how they got the name since it's almost the heaviest and thickest laptop in our list, but anyways, it has a gamery look, but that's what you can expect these days from a gaming laptop. It has a Core i5-8300H processor inside, which is actually faster than an i7-8550U. It also has fast 2666MHz DDR4 RAM and a GTX 1050 with 2GB of VRAM. It has a 1TB FireCuda solid state hybrid drive, something I had never heard about before, but they claim that it's 5 times faster than a traditional hard drive, which is still slower than an SSD. But if these claims are true, that's really nice. I don't really know what they were trying to do with the keyboard, especially the arrows, And I also don't really like the fact that the trackpad is so much off-center, but maybe some people will like it. Another great gaming rig you can pick up right now is the Acer Nitro 5 15-inch FHD gaming laptop. It has a 7th generation Intel Core i5 with 8 GB of DDR4 and a 256 GB SSD. It also has a 1050 Ti with 4 GB of VRAM. It still has some red accents, especially on the inside, but overall it doesn't scream gamer. And it is actually a really light laptop. At 2.56 pounds, it's one of the lightest laptops on the list. I don't really know if it's true or if it's an error, but if it's true, it's very impressive for a gaming laptop. The small storage can also be a con for some people, but don't worry, it's upgradable if you need more. You even have sellers that let you customize the RAM and storage. So you can normally get this base model for $720, but there is a sale going on at the moment where you can get it for $690. So if you're fast, you can maybe get it for a little less. Now we have the MSI GV62 8RD 215-inch Full HD Performance Gaming Laptop, a very well received laptop with 8.5 star rating on Amazon for only $800. But it's no wonder. This thing rocks the Core i5-8300H, 8 GB of RAM, an Nvidia GeForce GTX 1050 Ti, which is a decent portion better than the GTX 1050. It also has a 1TB 5400 RPM hard drive, but don't worry, it has 8 GB of the new Intel Optane memory, which uses machine learning to improve loading times and therefore takes care of the data transfer lag. It also has a backlit SteelSeries keyboard, which is really nice to type on and therefore a huge plus. The last laptop I will talk about is the Acer Aspire 7 casual gaming laptop, coming in at $950, but you get a lot for this price. You get a Core i7-8750H, it's like the bigger brother of the Core i7-8550U and gives it a significant boost. It also has an Nvidia GeForce GTX 1050 Ti with 4 GB of VRAM. It also has 8 GB of DDR4, a 128 GB SSD and a 1TB hard drive. It comes with a fingerprint scanner, which is nice. Something I personally like about this laptop is its casual design, so you won't get any strange looks when you walk into the class with this. If you take a look at the processors of the laptops, we can see that the base frequency of the Core i3 is higher than the Core i5, so it must be faster, right? Wrong, because a double amount of cores and threads, the Core i5-8250U is about average 30% faster. Furthermore, the difference between the Core i7-8550U and the Core i5-8250U isn't actually that big. In fact, it's really small. The Core i7 is just better at single core performance for about 5%. So this makes the Core i5-8250U actually a really good CPU for the price. The Core i5-8300H is about 20% faster than the Core i5-8250U, and so it is 15% better than the Core i5-8550U. If you look at the previous generation CPU in the Acer Nitro, it is about 25% less powerful than the Core i5-8300H. I'm not saying it's not capable of gaming. No, it can definitely play most of the games, but just with slower rendering. And then we have the Core i7-8750H. It blows all of the competitors out of the water. With 6 cores and 12 threads, it is 20% better than the Core i5-8300H, which makes it 43% faster than the Core i7-8550U and 45% faster than the Core i5-8250U. Then for the graphics cards, if you don't really need one, I should go with laptop you like most of the first category. If you have a higher budget than just $500 and you want a laptop with better quality, I should pick up the Asus VivoBook S. This one does have a graphics card, but it can always come in handy. And it also has a Core i7 and a good battery life. The Asus VivoBook Pro, on the other hand, is a typical laptop I see a graphical designer or a web designer use, or maybe a programmer that has no interest in gaming. The Nvidia GeForce MX150 is a weaker graphics card compared to the GTX 1050. The GTX 1050 is in fact about 50 to 70% faster. It even gets double the FPS in a lot of games. So if you want to game, The MX150 is okay, but you will only be able to play smaller titles like CSGO, League of Legends and Fortnite on low to medium settings. But on medium settings you will still have about 60 FPS, so don't worry if you want to play games on the MX150. If you then compare the GTX 1050 to the GTX 1050 Ti, you see that the 1050 Ti has about a 25% better performance than the GTX 1050. So that's also something to consider. Lastly, we have some other important comparisons, like the battery life. If you take a look, we can surprisingly see that the Acer Aspire E15 has a huge lead, with nobody even close, with 13.5 hours of battery life. It doesn't need much power, but boy oh boy, it has power for days. The other three cheaper notebooks have about the battery life that you can expect for a low-cost laptop like that. 5 to 7 hours isn't very much, but it's enough for most students since they don't need their laptop for every class. The laptops in the second category have a battery life that will get you through the day of school, with even some extra. The gaming laptops are another story. Some of them have as low as 4 hours of battery life, so make sure to bring your charger. It's understandable since this high-end hardware draws a lot of power. But the Acer Nitro and the Acer Aspire surprised me. These gaming laptops have a really nice battery life on paper, but don't be shook if this isn't the case when you get a laptop. My laptop personally also said it could go for 8 hours, but in reality I mostly get about 6 hours. For RAM there's not really much to say. The 16GB on the VivoBook Pro are a nice plus, but the 8GB is mostly enough for normal tasks. Maybe for some AAA titles, the 8GB of RAM might not be enough to play it on high settings. But still, if you want to upgrade to 16GB, then it's not the hardest thing to do with these laptops. Just buy an 8GB RAM stick and slide it in an open RAM slot, and then you're ready to go. It's only a shame that the RAM prices are so damn high, so yeah, maybe you can hopefully do this in the future. Also, the 6GB RAM was maybe expected for the Acer Aspire E15, but again, this is upgradable. But before you do that, I would highly suggest you to first upgrade your laptop with an SSD. A 128GB or 256GB stick will do the job. And that brings us to the storage. And the first thing I have to tell you is very sad news. All of the hard drives are only 5400 RPM. I don't really know why laptop manufacturers cheap out on them. A 7200 RPM hard drive is much better for a fraction of the cost more. So for all of the laptops in the first category, I would suggest to buy at least a 128GB SSD or a 256GB SSD. I will provide a link to one below. But really, it's worth the $40. Your PC will run so much better. And it's as easy as just unscrewing the back and placing it in the free M.2 slot. And then you're ready to go. For the Acer Nitro 5, you also maybe want a little bit more storage. But don't worry, it has a free spot for a 2.5 inch hard drive. So you can easily pick up a 1TB or 2TB hard drive with actually 7200 RPM and just slot it in. I will also provide a link to this below. For the sizes, I think there's not a lot to be said. 15 inch is about the standard for many laptops, so if you want a bigger or smaller laptop, you still have the choice between the VivoBook S and the VivoBook Pro. If you ask me what my personal preferences are, then I would say that the Acer Aspire E15 in the daily use category is the best, because it's just that cheap, and with the SSD inside you won't feel any difference with an $800 model for tasks like browsing or watching videos. Also, the 13 hour battery is a huge plus for me, so I don't need to worry about bringing my charger anywhere. In the all around category, I would go for the Acer VivoBook S, since the extra storage and RAM will not really be necessary for most use cases of this laptop. Also, it is a small and portable laptop with a nice battery life. I also don't mind the MX150 since most of the time I game at home, so the 1050 won't really be needed. But if I want to game on my laptop, the choice would be really hard and really depends on what my budget is. If I had a lot of money to spend, I would directly go for the Acer Aspire 7, since the CPU is just that much faster, and the battery life is higher, and it has enough storage for all the games I want to play, while having an SSD. But if I had a smaller budget, I would go for the Asus TUF Gaming FX504, because for the price it is just an incredible deal. so I wouldn't mind bringing my charger anywhere for that price. Also, the fast RAM and storage are also a huge plus. So that's the end of the video. All the links on where to buy the laptops are in the description. These are affiliate links, so by buying them with the link, you can support the channel for just the same price. Also, don't forget to like if this video was helpful, and maybe share the video with some of your friends that are searching for a laptop as well. You never know if it helps them out. If you want to see more of this, please let me know in the comments and by subscribing to the channel. We are almost at 200 subscribers, so yeah. Again, thanks for watching.